Hello everyone, in the last class we discussed distribution of identical things. In this lecture we are discussing problems based on distribution of identical things. So first problem of today's lecture is 4 boys picked up 30 mangoes. In how many ways can they divide them if all mangoes be identical? Here we have two problems. First problem is what? Each boy can receive any number of mangoes. Second is what? Each boy receive at least one mango. So these two problems we have to solve. So in this problem given is 4 boys picked up 30 mangoes. In how many ways can they divide them if all mangoes be identical? Okay, here we have two problems. First is each boy can receive any number of mangoes. Okay, second is what? Each boy receive at least one mango. Okay, so these two problems we have to solve. Now we are solving first problem. Okay, so here given is what? 30 mangoes. And all are identical. Okay, so these 30 mangoes we have to divide into 4 boys. Okay, so we can take 4 boys what? A, B, C and D. So these 30 mangoes we have to divide into A, B, C, D. Okay, so these are the 4 boys. Okay, suppose A is receiving X1 mangoes. B is receiving X2 mango, C is receiving X3 mango and D is receiving X4 mangoes. Okay, so according to first problem given is what? Each boy can receive any number of mangoes. Okay, so A can receive 0 mango also, 1 also, 2 also and all mangoes also. Okay, so A is receiving X1 mangoes. So X1 value should be what? Greater than or equal to 0 and less than or equal to 30, because A can receive any number of mangoes. Similarly, X2 also 0 to 30. So X2 also 0 to 30. Similarly, X3 also 0 to 30. And similarly, X4 also 0 to 30. Because given is what? Each boy can receive any number of mangoes. Okay. But this summation X1 plus X2 plus X3 plus X4, this should be what? Okay, total mangoes what? 30. We have to distribute 30 mangoes into 4 boys. That means this summation should be what? 30. Okay, so as we discussed in last class, this equation solution is nothing but distribution of 30 mangoes into 4 groups. Okay, so this distribution of 30 mangoes into 4 groups. Okay, and according to this condition, we can say that each group can receive any number of mangoes. Okay, so we have to distribute 30 mangoes into 4 groups. Okay, in such a way that each group can receive any number of mangoes. Okay, so this is nothing but 30 plus 4 minus 1 C 4 minus 1. So what will come? 33 C 3. This is your answer. Okay, so first for our answer is what? 33 C 3. Now we are solving second part. Second part is each boy receive at least one mango. So this we have to solve. So we have 30 mangoes. Okay, 30 mangoes we have to divide among 4 boys in such a way that each boy receive at least one mango. So first what you will do, we have 4 boys. Okay, and each receive at least one mango. So out of 30 mangoes, one mango you will give to A, one mango to B, one mango to C and one mango to D. Because given is what? Each boy receive at least one mangoes. So we are giving one mangoes to each boys. Okay, so remaining is how many mangoes? 26. So remaining mangoes is 26. So remaining is what? 26. Now there is no condition, because we already give one mangoes to each boys. Okay, so there is no condition. Now these 26 mangoes we have to divide among 4 boys in such a way that each boy can receive any number of mangoes. Okay, so A is receiving x1, B is receiving x2, C is receiving x3 and D is receiving x4. Okay, and we have 26 mangoes. Okay, so x1 can receive any number of mangoes. So x1 can get greater than or equal to 0 to less than or equal to 26. Similarly, x2 also, similarly x3 also and similarly x4 also. Okay, so I am writing 0 and less than or equal to 26. Okay, so this will be the condition. Okay, second is what? x1 plus x2 plus x3 plus x4, this should be equal to 26. We have to solve this one. Okay, so we have to divide 26 mangoes among 4 groups in such a way that blank group is allowed. Okay, so empty group is allowed. So what will come? 26 plus 4 minus 1 C 4 minus 1. So what will come? 29 C 3. This is your answer. Now we are discussing different type of problems, but you can solve these problems by using same method. So problem is, find the number of solution of x plus y plus z plus w equal to 20 under the following condition. Here we have three problems. First problem is, x is greater than or equal to 0, y is greater than or equal to 0, z is greater than or equal to 0, w is greater than or equal to 0. Second problem is, x is greater than or equal to 1, y is greater than or equal to 2, z is greater than or equal to 3, w is greater than or equal to 0. Third problem is, x is greater than or equal to minus 3, y is greater than or equal to minus 2, z is greater than or equal to 1, w is greater than or equal to 0. And given is, x, y, z, w belongs to integer. So this problem we have to solve. For solving this problem, we have two methods. First method is multinomial, that I will discuss later. Second method is what? Distribution of identical things, that I will use here. So problem is, find the number of solution of x plus y plus z plus w equal to 20 under the following condition. Okay, so we have three problems, and given is what? X, y, z, w belongs to integer. Okay, so we are solving first problem. Okay, so here given is what? X plus y plus z plus w equal to 20. Okay, so first condition is what? X is greater than or equal to 0, y is greater than or equal to 0, z is greater than or equal to 0, w is greater than or equal to 0. Okay, so we can take what? 20 identical things. Okay, so 20 identical things we have to divide into four groups. Okay, so first group is what? X, second is y, third is what? Z, and fourth is what? W. Okay, so we have four different group, x, y, z, w. So 20 identical things we have to divide into four group in such a way that blank group is allowed, because x is what? Greater than or equal to 0, y is greater than or equal to 0, z is greater than or equal to 0, and w is greater than or equal to 0. Okay, so if x is equal to 0, that means group x is having 0 things, that means group x is empty. Similarly, if y is having 0, so y equal to 0, then y group is what? Empty. Okay, so here we can say that empty group is allowed. Okay, so 20 identical things we have to divide into four groups. Okay, in such a way that empty group is allowed. So what will come? 20 plus 4 minus 1 c 4 minus 1. So what will come? 23 c 3. This is your answer. Okay, so first problem answer is what? 23 C 3. Now we are solving second part. Second part is, x is greater than or equal to 1, y is greater than or equal to 2, z is greater than or equal to 3, and w is greater than or equal to 0. Okay, so we have to find out number of solution of this equation, where x is greater than or equal to 1, y is greater than or equal to 2, z is greater than or equal to 3, and w is greater than or equal to 0. Okay, so this is second part. So we have to find out total number of solution of this equation where this condition is there. Okay, so what you will do? 1 we are taking in left hand side. So what will come? X minus 1 is greater than or equal to 0. Similarly, 2 we are taking left hand side. So what will come? Y minus 2 is greater than or equal to 0. Similarly, for 3 also, what will come? Z minus 3 greater than or equal to 0, and W is greater than or equal to 0. Okay, so what you will do? X minus 1 we are taking as T1. So X minus 1 we are taking T1. Okay, so what will come? T1 is greater than or equal to 0. Similarly, y minus 2 we are taking t2. So y minus 2 equal to t2. So what will come? T2 is greater than or equal to 0. Similarly, z minus 3 we are taking t3. So what will come? T3 is greater than or equal to 0, and w is as it is. Okay, so we got this condition. Now x, y, z will replace with t1, t2, t3. Okay, so x is what? T1 plus 1. So if you put here, so what will come? T1 plus 1. Okay, y what will come? T2 plus 2. So what will come? T2 plus 2 plus z. So z is what? T3 plus 3. T3 plus 3, and w as it is equal to 20. Okay, now if you simplify this one, what will come? T1 plus T2 plus T3 plus w equal to 20 minus, this is what? 1 plus 2 plus 3, so that is 6. So 6 will come in right hand side. So what will come? 20 minus 6. So what will come? T1 plus T2 plus T3 plus W equal to 20 minus 6, that is 14. Okay, here condition is what? T1 is what? Greater than equal to 0. T2 is greater than equal to 0. T3 is greater than equal to 0. And W is greater than equal to 0. Okay, so this we can solve. Okay, so we can take 14 identical things. So 14 identical things, we have to divide into 4 groups in such a way that blank group is allowed. So what will come? 14 plus 4 minus 1, C4 minus 1. So what will come? 14 plus 4 is what? 18. 18 minus 1 is what? 17. So 17 C3. This is your answer. Now I will discuss shortcut for finding second problem. Okay, so we are discussing shortcut. Okay, in shortcut what you will do? Okay, so x plus y plus z plus w is what? 20. Okay, so we have to find out number of solution of this equation where this condition is there. Okay, so what you will do? In this one condition is what? X is greater than equal to 1, y is greater than equal to 2, z is greater than equal to 0, and w is greater than equal to 0. Okay, so first add this one. 1 plus 2 plus 3. So what will come? 6. 1 plus 2 plus 3 is what? 6. Okay, so this 1 plus 2 plus 3, that is 6, we have to subtract from 20. Okay, so 1 plus 2 plus 3 is what? 6. That we have to subtract from 20. So what will come? 20 minus 6. Okay, and this is equal to x plus y plus z plus w. Okay, now we'll take x is what? Greater than equal to 0, y is greater than equal to 0, z is greater than equal to 0, w is greater than equal to 0. Okay, so what will come? X plus y plus z plus w equal to 14. Okay, so we got 14. Now 14 identical things we have to divide into 4 groups. So what will come? 14 plus 4 minus 1 c 4 minus 1. So 17 c 3. So this is your shortcut. Now we are solving third part. Third part is x is greater than equal to minus 3, y is greater than equal to minus 2, z is greater than equal to 1, and w is greater than equal to 0. Okay, so we are solving third part. Okay, here also we are using shortcut. Okay, so here condition is what? X is greater than equal to minus 3, y is greater than equal to minus 2, z is greater than equal to 1, w is greater than equal to 0. Okay, this condition is given. So what we will do? First we have to add this one, minus 3 plus minus 2 plus 1. So what will come? Minus 3 plus minus 2 is what? Minus 5 plus 1 is what? Minus 4. So what you will do? From 20 we have to subtract minus 4. So what will come? X plus y plus z plus w equal to 20 minus minus 4. Okay, so this summation is what? Minus 4. So we have to subtract from 20 minus 4. So what will come? X plus y plus z plus w equal to 20 minus minus 4. So what will come? 24. Okay, now here condition what will come? X is greater than equal to 0, y is greater than equal to 0, z is greater than equal to 0, w is greater than equal to 0. If you do this one, we'll get this one. Okay, now we have to distribute 24 identical things into 4 groups in such a way that blank group is allowed. So what will come? 24 plus 4 minus 1 c 4 minus 1. So what will come? 27 C3. This is your answer. So by using shortcut, we can solve these type of problems. We are discussing one more problem, that is find the number of solution of the equation x plus y plus z plus w is less than 31, where x is greater than equal to minus 3, y is greater than equal to 2, z is greater than equal to 4, 5, w is greater than equal to 5, and x, y, z, w belongs to integers. So we have to solve this problem. Okay, so we are solving this one. Okay, according to problem we have to find out total number of solution of the equation x plus y plus z plus w is less than 31, where x is greater than equal to minus 3, y is greater than equal to 2, z is greater than equal to 4, w is greater than equal to 5, and x, y, z, w belongs to integer. Okay, so this we have to solve. Now given is what? X, y, z, w is what? Integer. Then we can say that this summation is always integer. Okay, so left hand side summation is what? Always integer. So we can say that 31 is not possible, correct? Because it is given as what? Less than 31. Okay, so 31 is not possible, it should be integer only. So we can say that x plus y plus z plus w is always less than or equal to 30. Okay, 31 is not possible, so we can write this equation as what? X plus y plus z plus w is what? Less than or equal to 30. Okay, and condition is what? X is greater than or equal to minus 3. Okay, and y is greater than equal to 2, z is greater than equal to 4, and w is greater than equal to 5. Okay, now here we will use shortcut. Okay, shortcut. Okay, so according to shortcut, what you will do, we have to add this one, minus 3 plus 2, that is minus 1. Minus 1 plus 4 is what? 3. And 3 plus 5 is what? 8. Okay, so from this equation, from 30 we have to subtract 8. Okay, so what will come? X plus y plus z plus w is less than or equal to 30 minus 8. Okay, now what will come here? X will come what? Greater than or equal to 0. Y is greater than or equal to 0. Z is greater than or equal to 0. And w is greater than or equal to 0. Okay, so by using shortcut, we can convert this equation from here to here. Okay, so this will come X plus y plus z plus w is less than or equal to 22. Okay, here given is what? X is greater than or equal to 0, y is greater than or equal to 0, z is greater than or equal to 0, and w is greater than or equal to 0. Okay, so we have to find out total number of solution of this equation. Okay, but in this one, x plus y plus z plus w, okay, minimum summation is what? 0, and maximum is what? 22. Okay, so we have to find out total number of solution of this equation. So we have to find out total number of solution of the equation where x plus y plus z plus w is what? 0. Okay, plus we have to find out total number of solution of the equation where x plus y plus z plus w is what? 1. Similarly for 2 also we have to find out, and similarly for 22 also we have to find out. So we have to add all the 23 cases. Okay, so that is difficult. So to avoid this one, what you will do here, we are assuming one dummy variable. So in this one we are adding one dummy variable t. Okay, so where t is what? Greater than equal to 0 and less than equal to 22. Okay, so we are adding dummy variable. So what will come? X plus y plus z plus w plus t. Okay, so if we add dummy variable, then this will write equal to 22. Now here we will get all the 23 cases. Okay, so how we will get? If t value is what? 0. Okay, if t value is 0, then x plus y plus z plus w is what? 22. Okay, so that is first case. Okay, if t value is what? 1, then x plus y plus z plus w is what? 21. That is second case. Similarly, if t value is what? 2. Okay, then x plus y plus z plus w is what? 20. And similarly, if you increase the t value, okay, if t value is what? 21, then x plus y plus z plus w is what? 1. And if t value is what? 22, then x plus y plus z plus w is what? 22. So we are getting all the 23 cases. So if you increase t value from 0 to 22, okay, we will get all the 23 cases. So solution of this equation is nothing but what? Solution of this equation. Okay, and solution of this equation is nothing but solution of this problem. Okay, so we have to solve this equation. Okay, where x is what? Greater than or equal to 0, y is greater than or equal to 0, z is greater than or equal to 0, w is greater than or equal to 0, and t is also greater than or equal to 0. Okay, that means we have to divide 22 identical things into 5 groups in such a way that blank group is allowed. So what will come? 22 plus 5 minus 1, see 5 minus 1. Okay, so this will come 22 plus 5 is what? 27. 27 minus 1 is what? 26, see 4. This is your answer. So in this lecture we discuss problems based on distribution of identical things. In next lecture we'll start multinomial. If you like my video, please like, share and subscribe my channel. If you want to give any suggestion, you can comment on comment section.